Wonderful stories rarely begin in a small town. But this revolutionary story starts 32 years ago in Andhra Pradesh, a central province of South India, the home of Satish Kumar, a 12-year-old student. Born into a Hindu family, Satish proved to be a handful for his parents. His mother was distraught at his mischievous ways and wished he was never born. Before long, he was smoking, and to get money for cigarettes, he would gamble. One day, Satish heard the voice of a street evangelist preaching that Jesus Christ could transform lives. Intrigued by the message and disgusted with his own life, Satish prayed, "Jesus, if you can lead me away from this miserable life and make me a new person, I will serve you for the rest of my life." His life was transformed miraculously. True to his word, Dr. Satish Kumar began to preach Christ crucified at the tender age of 18. By God's leading, he established Calvary Youth Mission when he was just 21. God started using this young man to reach thousands of souls and brought a great revival wherever he went. Dr. Satish Kumar was ordained by the International Ministerial Council of Great Britain in 1998 and returned to established Calvary Temple, which is a purely Bible-based and mission-focused church where the uncompromised Word of God is the final authority. Dr. Satish Kumar preaches the accurate and pure Word of God to reach, revive, renew, and refill millions of lives. His simple and spirit-filled messages focused on salvation and sanctification have attracted millions of people and transformed countless lives. In the year 2003, he started preaching through television with one program on air. Today, over 500 sermons in various languages are broadcast each month on national and international channels, beaming to over 300 million viewers. In 2012, God asked Dr. Satish Kumar to build a sanctuary on a 12-acre land and assured him that even as he enabled Nehemiah to build the walls of Jerusalem in 52 days, he would also enable him to build Calvary Temple in just 52 days. It was impossible. Who could build a church with a capacity of 18,000 people in 52 days? In obedience, Dr. Satish Kumar laid the foundation of the Calvary Temple on the 11th of November, 2012. By God's awesome power, for the first time in world history, a completely air-conditioned and acoustically treated sanctuary, which can seat 18,000 people at a time, was completed in exactly 52 days. Calvary Temple came into its own. In a short span of 12 years, the church has grown dramatically, totaling 200,000 members, congregating in one campus each week, making Calvary Temple the largest church in the world. Over the last 4 years alone, 100,000 new members have been added to the temple, for whom an adjoining building with a capacity of 18,000 was erected. Today, the Calvary Temple can seat a staggering 35,000 members in each service, also indicating that Calvary Temple is the fastest growing church in the world. More recently, God laid on Dr. Satish Kumar's heart to establish Calvary Temple campus churches in various cities and states. In Amaravati, the new capital city of Andhra Pradesh state, these new churches have rapidly grown to nearly 10,000 members in just 2 months' time. Watching this unexplainable growth, Dr. Satish Kumar has now prayerfully decided and sought God's grace to build the largest church ever built in the entire world, a stadium with a seating capacity of over 52,000 people in each service. chosen a 12-year-old boy from a Hindu home to speak to the nations? Why is God attracting millions to listen to the simple word of God spoken in truth? What is God doing in a country with less than 3% Christians that will make it a light to the nations? God is a God of contrast. He usually takes the simple things of life to achieve great things. If He could build Calvary Temple on simple faith, imagine what He can do with the nations of the world. Perhaps through this experience, God is showing the world that He can turn the world upside down if only we stay true to His word. To Him be the glory, the honor, and the power. Amen.